Hey guys!
So last week, Avery took a cooking class and had so much fun.
We made pasta, which my mom has never made.
And you ate it.
We ate the cream.
Did I get a bite?
So now I'm gonna show her and you how to make it.
Let's do it. All right, so let's get started. Avery's made me wash my hands and this entire countertop. What is next?
So you might actually want to put on an apron too, because
it's a little messy, right?
Yeah.
Well, we don't have an extra apron, so she gets the one apron.
You need a cup of flour.
Okay.
2 eggs that are raw, a fork, and you might either need extra water or extra flour. So first we need to put our cup of flour down, and
right
we need to form
here.
A mountain. It's very soft, so you'll like it.
Okay.
Nice, tall, steep mountain. Then you'll take 1 egg.
Okay.
And you'll go like this. You'll kind of make like a little circle. And be aware that we're cracking 2 eggs in here,
raw eggs. Raw eggs.
So you might want to make it kind of like thick almost.
Okay.
I'm gonna crack my first egg. Okay, I'm terrible at cracking eggs, I'm warning you.
Woo!
I did it without any cracks.
Well, woo!
Then you crack your second egg.
Okay.
Now if your fork, you're gonna whisk it.
So you're breaking up the yolk?
Yeah.
Okay.
Don't worry, it's gonna break.
Ooh,
so
look at mine. Is that?
No, that's fine. Mom, you're too neat.
I'm too neat?
Yes.
Oh, I'm too worried about it? Okay.
Yeah. You can take as much time as you'd like. Well, unless if you're waiting for dinner.
So Avery came home from this cooking class and spent all weekend perfecting her method, guys. She worked very hard for you.
Practice makes perfect.
How do you know if it's looking good?
Well, it kind of is bunching up a little,
okay.
I guess. But as I said, you might need more water if it's like too dry.
Okay.
Or you might need more flour if it's too wet.
Why do sometimes you need more flour and sometimes you need more water?
Well, because sometimes the egg is bigger, so that depends on everything.
The eggs aren't perfect size, right?
They're not all the same size or else the world would just be weird. And now actually we're gonna start using our hands.
The moment I've been waiting for.
Every chef's favorite tool. And then when it's getting tough, like really tough to do this,
okay.
You know it's like time to go.
Oh, that's how you know. Okay.
Yeah.
That's what I was looking for, a little hint. I go like this, and then I fold it over.
Yeah.
Got it.
Okay, so I think my dough's about ready. Our dough is done. So now we are going to thin it out. I gave my mom the hard job, which is with a rolling pin.
All right, okay. And we cleaned our surface off too, guys, so it wouldn't be all sticky. Okay.
Yeah.
Is this good?
No, not at all.
Not
you
at all.
How thin it has to be and how long.
So, okay, so you're using a pasta attachment for a mixer.
Yeah.
Okay.
First, you have to set it to 1. So I'm just gonna put
That's
it
like
in.
That's like the widest setting.
Yeah.
That is so cool and so much easier. I definitely got the harder job.
Yeah. It's a little sticky, so we're gonna add some flour.
Right.
And then, Mom, that's a lot of flour. Then you have to fold it no matter what.
Okay, do I need to fold mine or can I just keep going?
No, you have to keep on going. You're not folding it. And then I'm gonna put it back through.
Don't mind me, I'm just still rolling over here.
You have to, oh, that's actually pretty
good.
Good,
right?
Yeah.
I'm feeling good about myself.
You should be. I'm gonna turn it to 2.
2, okay, so we're making it thinner now, right? Now, you went to 2, how far up do you go? Because there's
5.
8 on here. Okay, so you go to 5 of 8. How many times do you put it through each one, like twice?
Oh, yeah.
Okay.
And?
You need like multiple hands catching it? You want my help?
Maybe a little, but Mom, you need some work too.
I still need work?
Now I'm just gonna go up to 3.
Woo-hoo.
We're gonna pop it and go to 5. See, and it's kind of like smooth and pretty.
It's really like awesome. I can't believe how much the texture has changed.
Yeah, and we're done.
Should have worn an apron. All right, what's next?
So now our dough is done. So we are gonna make our shape.
What shape are we making?
A bow.
A bow, butterfly. What are they called in Italian? Farfalle. What do we do? Oh, Avery's using the pizza cutter again with the easy way.
Basically, just make strips like this.
So how thick, like an inch thick?
Yeah.
Okay, an inch thick.
You could even make, for this, like, you can make your bow ties into like a fun, strange way.
Ooh. I wonder how you do like corkscrew pasta or like fusilli or something.
Yeah, that's probably a lot more complicated.
Yeah, probably.
Next, you're gonna cut a rectangle.
Okay.
And then you're just gonna go like this. It's so hard to make.
I think that was sarcasm.
It was.
Okay, you're just pinching it?
Yeah. I think this will be enough for Brooks and Ryder for dinner tonight.
I don't know, they seem pretty hungry.
Yeah, but then the
thing. Wait, what about
one,
me and Daddy? We don't get any?
Woohoo! Okay, so we got our pasta already.
Ta-da!
Mom's got the water boiling.
And now we gotta cook it. Now, cooking time does vary, right? When it's thicker,
like
it can be longer, right? So anywhere I would say from like 3 to 10 minutes when we were experimenting, that's about right, yeah?
Mm-hmm.
Okay. All right, the pasta is off of the stove and it smells amazing.
Yeah. Cheesy, buttery, even better than store-bought.
Should we have the boys try it?
Definitely.
Pasta, pasta, pasta.
Mmm. Thank you, baby. This is delicious. This is better than the stuff that Mom buys.
All right, well, that wraps up our pasta episode. Thank you so much for showing me how it's done.
If you like this episode, stay tuned.
Because next time we're doing
sauces and ravioli.
All right, time to manja. Bye, guys.
Italy!
2, 3, action. You're going to see that.
Oh.
Just go into that.
Oh. I might have seen a few eggshells in there.
No.
Oh, well. And we're just going to cut them up and you'll see.
Happy birthday to you, you're 102.
So thanks to Eve for helping me. Oh, 1, 2, 3.
Hugging.